Dear students, today I would like to discuss the Fischer-Tropsch process. Myself, Dr. Digna Varghese. Fischer-Tropsch process or FT process. The Fischer-Tropsch process is a collection of chemical reactions that converts a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen into liquid hydrocarbons. In other words, FT process is the catalytic hydrogenation of carbon monoxide. These reactions occur in the presence of metal catalyst, typically at temperatures of 150 to 300 degrees Celsius and pressures of 1 to several tens of atmospheres. The process was first developed by Franz Fischer and Hans Tropsch at the Kaiser Wilhelm Institute in Mülheim an der Ruhr, Germany in 1925. This process is also known for the synthesis of gasoline or petrol. We know gasoline is a clear petroleum-derived flammable liquid that is used as a fuel in most spark-ignited internal combustion engines. The Fischer-Tropsch process is a gas-to-liquid polymerization technique that turns a carbon source into hydrocarbon chains through the hydrogenation of carbon monoxide by means of a metal catalyst. In this carbon source treated with steam and forming carbon monoxide and hydrogen, that is synthesis gas. A process of gasification where a controlled flow of steam and oxygen is maintained through the source at high temperatures and pressures without enough oxygen for complete combustion. The feedstock for carbon source is typically coal or natural gas or even carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide can be removed from the ocean or the atmosphere, have been considered here. The raw material for the carbon source is maybe coal or natural gas. Natural gas, the main component of the natural gas is methane or even carbon dioxide. Biomass could serve as feedstock, but it is not cost competitive for transport fuels. The carbon source is converted to syngas or synthesis gas, that is a combination of carbon monoxide and hydrogen. Synthesis gas is the starting point for many industrial chemicals. Preparation of synthesis gas or syngas currently is by reforming methane. Methane is actually the principal component of natural gas. Methane on treated with water giving hydrogen and carbon monoxide, that is syngas or synthesis gas. This actually done by using a methane reformer. Methane reformer is a device used for steam reforming or steam methane reforming. Steam methane reforming is a method for producing syngas by the reaction of hydrocarbon with water. It's a metal catalyst surface in which the methane is adsorbed and water is also adsorbed on this and forming carbon monoxide and hydrogen by this reaction. This is actually the process involved in methane reformer. So methane react with the water forming synthesis gas or syngas. Different feedstocks and syngas production mechanisms produce different hydrogen carbon monoxide ratios. Coal gasification produces ratios close to unity. Cold gasification is the process of producing syngas. That is, carbon reacts with water giving carbon monoxide and hydrogen. Cold gasified to produce cold gas or town gas. This ratio, hydrogen to carbon monoxide ratio, is approximately 1. But in steam form reforming of natural gas produces the ratio of 3:1. The syngas production process consumes 60-70% of the capital and running cost of the plant, so the proper ratio for the Fischer-Tropsch reaction must be maintained to maximize syngas conversion efficiency. The resulting syngas is passed through a metal catalyst, which causes polymerization into hydrocarbon chains via the reaction. Syngas passed through a metal catalyst, which causes polymerization into hydrocarbon, where CnHn H2n plus 2 represents a range of hydrocarbons ranging from low molecular weight gases, that is N is equal to 1, that for methane, by way of gasoline N is equal to 5 to 12, for diesel fuel N is equal to 13 to 17, and as for ferrous solid waxes N greater than 17. The FT reaction is usually a catalytic reaction at high temperatures and high pressures for realistic rates to be achieved, and the typical catalysts used are based on iron or cobalt. The hydrocarbons produced by FT process can be refined and used in place of more conventional liquid fuels derived from crude oil. Synthetic fuel can be produced by a variety of gasification methods, with gas to liquid, coal to liquid, and biomass to liquid being the most widespread. Fischer-Tropsch process is the reaction offer an attractive potential for the organic chemical industry. Conversion of carbon monoxide and hydrogen, that is syngas, to hydrocarbons and oxygenated products with the help of heterogeneous catalyst. Hydrogen acts as a reducing agent here. The reaction may be viewed as the reduction of carbon monoxide followed by polymerization in some times over a variety of catalytic surfaces. Examples for the catalytic surfaces: iron, nickel or ruthenium on alumina or other surfaces, as well as cobalt, chromium or other oxides. The synthesis of methanol by the reduction of carbon monoxide is now commercial process and employs copper promoter zinc oxide catalyst at 250 degrees Celsius and 50 atmospheric pressures. Carbon monoxide and hydrogen is converted to methanol by a copper-based catalyst. This methanol can be converted industrially into gasoline. The process of conversion of methanol into gasoline recently by Mobil Oil Company and utilizes a framework of silicates. Here, using silicate is zeolite, ZSM-5 category, with specially contrived cavity and channel dimension. Mobil, previously known as the Saucony Vacuum Oil Company, is a major American oil company that merged with Exxon in 1999 to form a parent company called ExxonMobil. By this reaction, that is synthesis, gas can be converted into several compounds based on catalyst, that it can be converted into formaldehyde, methanol, methane, alcohols and alkenes and hydrocarbons. So this reaction is industrially very important reaction, that is from one carbon feedstock we can polymerize to several number of carbon products. The zeolite acts as an acid catalyst, and in effect it removes a molecule of water from methanol. The carbene may be stabilized by zeolite to be available for insertion in another molecule of methanol. Here methanol, which is converted into gasoline or hydrocarbon or carbene chain by the catalyst ZSM5. This is an acid catalyst. This is the molecular structure of ZSM5. ZSM5 catalyst was first synthesized by Aragur and Landolt in 1969. It is a medium pore size zeolite with channels defined by 10 membered rings. The synthesis involves the solution is the source of alumina, sodium ions and hydroxide ions. In the presence of excess base, the alumina will form soluble AlOH4 minus ions. Second solution has the tetrapropyl ammonium cation that acts as a templating agent, and the third solution is the source of silica. Mixing the three solutions produces a supersaturated tetrapropyl ammonium ZSM5, which can be heated to recrystallize and produce a solid ZSM5. The pore size of the zeolite catalyst ZSM5 is so chosen that it is just right for a gasoline molecule CH2 n times, allowing the insertion of CH2 groups to continue up to the formation of C6 to C10 chain. Mechanism of this reaction is not clear. Over 99% of methanol is converted to gasoline in a single pass. In FT process, the reduction of CO presumably proceeds via formyl and hydroxymethyl intermediates to form methane by triosmium dodecacarbonyl, that is OS3CO12, as catalyst. Since the Fischer-Tropsch process reaction is exothermic, excess heat needs to be removed to avoid deactivating the catalyst and increasing methane production. This is the mechanism proposed for this catalyst. This is a trimethyl catalyst, carbonyl catalyst, which is hydrogenated and giving this type of product, and on hydrogenation further giving COH, H, and by the removal of water and further adding hydrogen, CH2, which is joined to metal, and further hydrogenation giving methane. Indirect evidence for the formation of formyl types derivatives is X-ray diffraction or any spectrochemical evidence. The Fischer-Tropsch reaction can be visualized as a repeated chain growth process. Hydrogen is added, the CO bond is broken, and a new carbon-carbon bond is created. That is the hydrogenation of carbon monoxide forming CH2 plus water. The CO adsorption onto the catalyst surface can either be dissociative, C plus O, separately attached to the surface, or non-dissociative, that is CO attached to the surface. two mechanisms or two questions arises now. Whether hydrogen is first added to the adsorbed CO or whether the CO bond is first split. In the mechanism, there is two questions arises. The CO adsorption onto the catalyst surface can either be dissociative or non-dissociative. Fischer proposed this mechanism, a carbide type mechanism. Carbon monoxide and hydrogen are dissociatively adsorbed onto the catalyst surface. The carbon and oxygen are hydrogenated. The water desorbs and the adsorbed CH2 continues the polymerization process. The reaction may be viewed as the reductive polymerization of carbon monoxide with molecular hydrogen as the reducing agent. A variety of heterogeneous catalysts such as metallic cation and cobalt ion on alumina have been used. It is believed that carbon monoxide dissociates on the catalytic surface to give carbides and that these reactions are then hydrogenated to surface carbenes. Carbene insertion into a metal hydrogen bond gives a methyl group, and that can undergo carbene insertion in a propagating manner. In this metal surface, carbon monoxide, which is dissociatively associated on the or adsorbed on the catalyst surface to give carbides. Then carbide undergo insertion, carbene insertion, and forming a methyl group. That carbene insertion occur in a propagating manner. Therefore, this is actually done by the reductive polymerization of carbon monoxide with molecular hydrogen as reducing agent. Once again, I will tell you what are the reactions are taking place in a FT reactor, that is a metal surface, a metal catalyst surface is here, and the reactant species is synthesis gas, that is carbon monoxide and hydrogen. It is dissociatively adsorbed onto the catalyst surface as carbon and oxygen and hydrogen and hydrogen. And the catalyst surface, the carbon and oxygen are hydrogenated separately and it forms carbene and water. And the water desorbs carbene adsorbed here on the metal surface. And the CH2 formation continues. The polymerization process occurs. By this, carbon-carbon-carbon chain forms and a polymer is formed, that is production of gasoline or any other hydrocarbons or any other polymer or any other product can be prepared by this method. So in an FT reactor, carbon monoxide and hydrogen, that is synthesis gas, are dissociatively adsorbed onto the catalyst surface and the carbon and oxygen are separately hydrogenated. The water desorbs and CH2 groups adsorbed on the metallic catalyst surface, and when the termination occurs, this can be converted into gasoline or diesel or waxes or any other product by this simple one carbon reactant. So it is an important reaction. The number of experiments that support the carbide-carbon mechanistic proposal. First one is a model compound for the carbide proposal is a butterfly cluster formed from an unusual six-coordinate carbide. This carbide mechanism also been proposed recently. This is based on the observation of the remarkable reactivity of the encapsulated carbon in Fe6CCO16 2-, when exposed by a loss of two vertices from the original cluster, as demonstrated in the synthesis of carbomethoxymethylodiline cluster in by the oxidative fragmentation in methanol. So this is the exposed carbon. The exposed carbide-carbon reacts successively with carbon monoxide first and forming a carbon-carbon bond, followed by addition of methanol and hydrogenation to yield methyl acetate. A carbon-carbon bond is formed by this reaction. The net synthesis produces an organic oxygenated from synthesis gas, which may also occur in the Fischer-Tropsch reaction. Steps involved in FT process is the associative adsorption of CO, then splitting of the CO bond, dissociative adsorption of hydrogen, transfer of hydrogen to the oxygen to yield water, desorption of water, transfer of hydrogen to the carbon to yield CH2 and undergo polymerization reaction. Flow diagram of FT process is shown here. In this, we know FT process or Fischer-Tropsch process is the catalytic hydrogenation of carbon monoxide to hydrocarbons and oxygenated products with the help of heterogeneous catalyst. In this, we are using natural gas as the raw material or feedstock. We can also use coke or charcoal or any other carbon containing compounds such as carbon dioxide or biomass. Even we can use, and here we are using methane from the natural gas, which is passed to the scrubber unit, and steam is passed to the scrubber unit, and methane and steam come to the reformer, methane reformer unit. Methane reformer unit or methane reformer is a device used for steam reforming or steam methane reforming, which is a method used for producing syn gas by reaction of hydrocarbon with water. Here hydrocarbon is methane, and by the reaction of water forming syn gas, that is methane on water giving hydrogen and carbon monoxide. This is passed to the membrane separator, and here we will get pure syn gas as carbon monoxide and hydrogen, which is then passed to the Fischer-Tropsch reactor. In FT reactor, carbon monoxide and hydrogen are dissociatively adsorbed onto the catalyst surface. The CO as carbon and oxygen are hydrogenated. The water desorbs and the adsorbed CH2 continues the polymerization process. Here the reaction occurs in this way: carbon monoxide reacts with hydrogen and giving hydrocarbon and water. This passed to the separator unit. Water is separated here, and the hydrocarbon produced is in the form of liquid, so it is a gas to liquid polymerization technique, GTL, and here the liquid hydrocarbons. If a lighter hydrocarbon, if n is equal to 1, it is methane. That methane is converted to again to the scrubber unit. Other high molecular weight liquid hydrocarbons pass to the hydrocracker units and is collected here. If it is gasoline, n is equal to 5 to 12, that is petrol. If it is diesel, n is equal to 13 to 17. If it is a wax, n is greater than 17. So many products can be prepared by this simple reaction, by the simple one unit carbon containing reactant. So this is an industrially important reaction, and it is based on the heterogeneous catalyst, and it is a heterogeneous catalysis reaction, and it is the conversion of carbon monoxide and hydrogen into various hydrocarbons or oxygenated products. And the evidence for this reaction is from X-ray methods, single crystal X-ray diffraction techniques, or any other X-ray methods, IR methods or NMR methods, or any spectroscopic methods. The product is supported, and it is industrially important reaction. Thank you for your attention.